This is NBC 15 News at 6.
Now at 6, the quick thinking of some good Samaritans could be the reason 6 people are still alive today. Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. I'm John Stofflett. Lee will be back at 10. It was a relaxing afternoon that nearly turned tragic on the Rock River. 6 people, including 3 children, are swept down river, rescued by quick thinking good Samaritans. NBC 15's Chris Woodard is here with more.
John, this is a situation that very easily could have been much worse. It turned out to be the life-saving case of several people in the right place at the right time.
And all of a sudden, we could hear people like saying, help me, or something like that. They just sounded like they were in trouble.
Those screams shattered an otherwise very average afternoon on the Rock River for Carrie Christofferson. Parked on a sandbar in the town of Beloit, like they often do, her family moved quickly to help. 6 people, including 3 children, were out of their boat and had been swept downriver.
The current was really fast. The water was like knee-deep at the sandbar to begin with.
Christofferson's husband and brother jumped in their boat and raced to those in trouble. Along with another man, they began pulling people out of the water.
Those men got tired fast, and the kids were panicking, pushing them under the water. He said that that man was going underwater, you know, and he jumped in right after him, and he got him right away and pulled him up onto the boat.
Across town, the fire department already had all of their equipment out and were actually preparing to practice a swift water rescue that night when they got the call.
Right here off this point.
By the time they got to the river, the Good Samaritans were already rushing the victims to shore.
They are the true heroes here because they actually made a difference in at least one of the gentlemen's lives, if not 2.
And firefighters know without them, it could have been a much different story.
Much worse. It probably would have turned into a recovery more so than transferring to the hospital alive.
We were able to speak with at least 2 of the rescuers tonight, but they declined to go on camera, saying they just did what needed to be done.